eventually torch. In fact, no, the people did a lot of research to establish this one. When I was in doing my PhD, I could see a special movie made by National Geographic Channel to construct how the fire was invented. If you see this particular series of events, which help in understanding the events which led to this particular thing. The people say that a primitive human discovered this fire by chance. There was no intention, no planning to invent a fire at all. And before this invention, he was living inside the cave, and he fears to the, almost all the animals available around him. Well before the sunset, he has to run inside the cave and hide himself. And he doesn't have to do, he can't do anything after that when there is no sunlight. The first time when he invented the fire, and he got the most important aspect in his life. You see this one, his entire cave became a big laboratory. One of the most powerful equipment in his laboratory is the fire. He started developing thinking. You see this one is a two-way process. The first time the humans started doing the important quality for which they born, that is the extrasomatic action, the creating more CO2 than any other species and consuming energy more outside the body than the inside body. All these things started, and his entire cave became the big laboratory. And there is no argument on this that the most ancient culture on this globe, approved by any history on the globe, is Vedic culture. If you see, all those learned people always work with these fires in the name of holy fires. Their inventions, their thinking process, their development, everything centered around this particular fire. This fire slowly moved into many aspects of this particular engineering. And what is the next important engineering action which evolved out of this fire? You see this one? In fact, to get this picture, I worked at least 3 months on the Google with various words. I don't know, should there be a picture like this or not? But my thinking, my learning, that there should be a picture of this kind. Can you see this great and experienced person? Okay, who perhaps the first person discovered the fire and developed the attitude to create a fire, nurture a fire, sustain a fire, working with the fire. And he's giving demonstration to many of his fellow men, as the demonstration. You see these people. In fact, one of the surprising thing, you take any other heterotroph on this globe, you never see one heterotroph teaching to all heterotrophs. Only the teacher for anybody is the mother. Mother will teach its own children how to eat, how to get food, how to behave, maybe that's all. But it is the only the human race, one person without any connection to the other will start teaching. The art of teacher and student started because of this extrasomatic action. The first classroom on this globe perhaps is satisfying the extrasomatic action. This person started teaching them how to collect, what kind of wood will help, how much wood is required for the entire night. In fact, I was reading through some other history, they want to convey this much wood is required for the whole night, and they don't have a numbers. They use it to grunt. Ho means one, ho ho two. Then they thought that grunting so many times is a problem. They eventually invented the numbers. You see, any development which you see, the origin goes to the fundamental extrasomatic action. So let me take a fast historic trip, because this is not the one which we want to start. We want to start one of the powerful action led to this particular science. What is that powerful action which led to this particular science? The equipment for enhancing the utility of the fire. The people were developing. So you see, the research started how to create an artificial fire within the cave, within the residence. How to sustain that one, how to economize the fuel in this. Then they started thinking that, can I develop extra equipment which will enhance the utility of the fire? Only this fire is for the sake of light, warmth, etc. can I have a much more? So this is where all of you know, very ancient bonfire, the people started hanging the food on the bottom and started making the fire using the wood. The first time they processed the raw food before eating. This helped them improving their characteristic. They started growing healthy. The processing of fruit was the next innovation which went into the extra somatic action. You see this one, before I take the food in my body and create the energy, I spend more energy on that food to process, which is an extra somatic, more energy. And these kind of equipments created a series of more and more, mean processing the food led to next one. Then I think this might have taken a few million years or a billion years. The people developed what is called an intermediary substance being heated. Like water became one of the important constituent to process any food, like boiled food, which we think very much careful, but that required, that created inherently a science. And let me show you, obviously for our own health, we developed an important thing, and the development of the steam created the novel ideas. The first engineering extrasomatic action and recorded on the globe, other than eating, processing the food, etc. This particular one, all of you know from lot of historical thing, as early as 130 BC, there was a philosopher and mathematician called a Hero. He belongs to a place called Alexandria. He used to draw, sketch, and give many, many philosophical approaches. But unfortunately, he's a philosopher and mathematician, not an engineer, never developed his idea translated into. This is the Hero of Alexandria. And in fact, if you read his autobiography, he thinks, I am a philosopher. I can preach and give the new ideas for a better living. It is the people, poor people, who should cash these things into engineering. That was his philosophy of thinking. What is his invention? You can see, this is called a yellow pile. And the bottom of this particular yellow pile is something like a boiler, a container of water. This particular one is heated with the fuel. You can see the fuel. Means, slowly people started equipment. What it started was directly heating the food, then indirect heating of the food. Now, that led to development of a steam. Now, this particular steam will have a huge amount of energy. Now, you can see, this, he sketched an event, and this particular boiler will have two pipes. You can see this pipe and this pipe. Okay, this is one pipe and this is the other pipe, and these are the supports come hollow pipes through which steam will enter, and there is a bearing supporting a spherical vessel. At the end of that, there were nozzles. In fact, no, all the thermodynamics which you take something like 2 years to learn is depicted in this particular one. How to convert a fuel energy into steam enthalpy, how to convert the steam enthalpy into kinetic energy, how to use this kinetic energy to produce a motion. Even now, if you go to world-class institutes like MIT, Stanford, etc., the first engineering project given to the student is to make a yellow pile and make it running. And they'll get a 20,000 RPM, 30,000 RPM, 40,000 RPM without any load on it. Means, so he started first time a powerful concept for the engineering. What is this one? The motion from heat. Otherwise, what was the way of getting the motion before? Only from the animals, or a waterfalls, or a wind. Now, first time he created a motion indirectly. Whatever you want, whatever quantity you want, whenever you want. Suppose if I depend on the wind, whenever there is a wind, then only I'll get a motion. Suppose if I depend on the animals, if the animal is not happy and not behaving, I cannot get the motion. But the moment it is a fuel-centered, heat-centered motion, I can have as much I want. Of course, resources have to be available. First time, his growth on extrasomatic side has come to engineering version, not to depend on the whatever availability. And in this process, or the idea of the Hero, this yellow pile, make the people to work with the more with the water. People started doing every kind of heating with the water and produced in the history of scientific. This is one of the fundamental and primitive scientific theory. Though for us, no, it looks obvious. For us, no, because we taught so much science indirectly, this looks like obvious scientific thing. What is the one? The first one. So he thought the water and steam can be used as a carrier of heat. So instead of directly, suppose if you take some amount of rice and you directly expose it to the heat, you get nothing. In fact, all will get burnt and become a carbon. Suppose if I use water as a carrier, then the value of the food increases. So that particular one, he took all the way to engineering. How these can be. So in that particular process, he wanted to quantify. He wanted to get what is called a numerical engineering, number-based engineering from the process-based. See, it is well known that water boils at 100 degrees Celsius when it is exposed to atmospheric pressure. This was the first number realization in the engineering history. So the moment he got the number, then he started thinking, is it only 100 I can get with the water? Can I create a more or a less? So that took many, many years of research. In fact, the good amount of research which led to the development of thermodynamics is, even now when you go to the properties of substance, though it is a property of a few substance, 95% of your knowledge related to the substances are centered around the water, steam. Why? Historically also, the water and steam played so much role in the development of extrasomatic engineering devices. The people started playing with this, then they understood that there is a correspondence between the pressure and saturation temperature, which we'll learn more thoroughly. And he could create any temperature in the environment. If he want, with the same fire, he can create 100, 120, 140, 200, 250, whatever temperature he wants, he can create in the his equipment, in his laboratory. What he should do, he has to select an intermediate substance along with the fire. If he uses a fire, then there is no control of temperature. You can see this origin of thermodynamics, why thermodynamic concepts are so powerful. Everything is based on the experience and historical development. And he understood finally the concept called evaporation. During the evaporation, temperature not changing. Then he developed the words like latent heat, etc., which you learnt in your fundamental physics in 11th or 12th or before that. So what I want to say is his extrasomatic action led to a series of innovations. All these innovations got organized for the sake of better understanding. Why? A person who invented wanted to tell the same thing to the others, which doesn't happen. I don't have any relation to thousands and thousands of students which listen to me, but still I want to share it. This is one of the extrasomatic behavior. To communicate, no, I need to process the information which I know in a proper way, articulate in a particular aspect, then develop the rules, regulations and theorems. So which entire thing, the basis of this. Now you imagine, 130 BC, the hero of Alexandria sketched a equipment, but nobody made as it is, nobody could develop that one. You can see this one, the first most appreciated production of motion from the heat is, there may be few things in between, I am taking the most significant things. In 1629, the Branca developed a wheel. You could see this one, he constructed, he sketched, he did everything. You can see what he is trying to do. Okay, so he is trying to do all the principles suggested by the hero of Alexandria and understood the science. So he constructed a boiler like a human body, and he created a mouth. You see, this is the mouth to which he connected a small nozzle. So whenever I burn the fuel, okay, and generate the heat, that heat is transferred to this particular vessel looking like a human body, and it is a full of water. The water will eventually boil and come through this particular one. Then he created a wheel, because by that time Newton's laws started coming up. the people understood how to create a force and whenever there is an action and how to use the reaction for your purpose. You see this one, whenever the steam incident on this particular wheel, that wheel try to change the direction of the steam, that is the action. But in return, the steam will push the wheel, that is the reaction. And what did he do? He used the that particular reaction indirectly or directly. This is the wheel which is rotating. That entire thing he converted into pumping the water. Now you see this one, the first classical constructed and following the ideas of hero are seen here. And he is producing the motion, pumping out the water from the deep wells or mines or so. And what is the input? The fuel energy, the fire to motion, which led all kinds of interesting events to start up. And the people started working and developing. But what I consider is the next person who tried to modify the Branca's steam turbine. The Branca's steam turbine is the one which is the initiation. But this particular person, Thomas Savery, okay, and he totally changed the concept into a different device which is called a reciprocating steam engines. And he developed his own way of utilizing the power of steam for the sake of motion. And that's how now he stands in the first person who formalized the event rather than developing the equipment. Perhaps I'll come back to this one as one of the example to understand what he tried to say. Okay, and okay, what this particular person did is actually Thomas Savery, not only a mathematician, he is what is called a natural philosopher. So whenever he develops an engineering device or a mathematical model, he tried to observe the nature. What he saw is, he found that the nature is full of cycles. See, all of us learned these particular cycles in our life. We said there is a water cycle, there is an oxygen cycle, there is a nitrogen cycle, there are seasonal cycles. What he thought that whatever equipment or whatever process which he is going to develop, it should look like a cycle, not just attempting the entire thing. So if you see what the Thomas Savery is, the big engine, no? I'm trying to sketch. Why I'm sketching here is the origin of the fundamental and a classical thermodynamics will come from this original idea. He selected one big tank, okay? So one big cylindrical tank. One big cylindrical tank. At the bottom, he connected it to a water reservoir through a pipeline. This is the big water reservoir. Okay. Now he wanted to suck the water through this. Is it? Okay, maybe I'll bring this particular one in appropriate way. He appreciated the natures of the cycle. You can see this one. The beauty of the nature is, even the rock completely gets a cycle. Even the rock is not constant. A hill will be subjected to the wind, water, etc. Eventually it becomes dust, and the dust is carried to long far and falls on the ground, and it will be taken inside and goes as close as to the magma, and then eventually it will come out as a ignition rocks and will become again the hills. So there is a continuous thing, the solar energy continuously feeds the rock cycle. Means anything which is surviving for a very long time should work in a cycle, the way seasons go for so many, many, many years. This Thomas Savery, who is a natural philosopher, he designed his equipment in such a way that the natural philosophy is built into the invention and developed an equipment which was working in a cycle. That's how thermodynamics has one of the strong concepts. Whenever you are developing an equipment, you understand what is the cyclic nature of that one. Without understanding, you cannot develop the equipment at all. before the auto and diesel, many people tried to develop the engines, but they did not define properly what is the cycle based on which the engine should work. So that's how the I admired the philosophy of the, you can see the many interactions in the cycle. So that's what the Thomas Sever is thinking. This is called, I believe, my research proof. What is happening? No, sorry. The Thomas Savery believed in a natural concept, and observing this, if you want to produce any equipment and if you want that equipment to last long, this is the philosophy of a Thomas Savery, which he converted into equipment. And you see, it's taking time, isn't it? Okay, so let me explain now. So he selected a cylindrical vessel. In fact, he has given a peculiar name, maybe in Greek some name, and this is connected with a pipeline, and this was taken all the way down to some underground water or so. Now the thing is, this water should rise for the sake of better civilization, construction of cities, etc. Our mines are getting flooded with the water. Those were the issues after inventing the fuel. Now how do I suck this particular one? For this one, he did a big construction based on a cyclic process. On the top, he connected another pipeline. Okay. And this pipeline, perhaps he would have used some valves, etc., was connected to the big boiler, which everybody was inventing that time, filled with water. Why I am drawing this particular one now? You should appreciate the power of thermodynamic cycle to create an equipment. The people take it granted that there is a cycle definition, just you by heart the definition, it will come. You see, the greatest innovations will come with a simple concepts. Now you see, so he started burning the fuel that created a steam. Then he opened the valve, filled this entire tank with the steam. Okay, so the steam may go all the way to this. Okay, so after that, what he did after filling the entire thing, he closed this valve again, close it. Okay, you see the event one. The first event is open the valve, fill the cylinder with the steam. Once the cylinder fills with the steam, close the valve. And he poured some water onto this. So when I cool this entire cylinder with the water, all the steam will condense. The specific volume decreased to 1000, and there is a huge vacuum created. Now the pressure inside the cylinder is much, much less than the atmospheric. Now you see, this is the water body on which there is an atmospheric pressure working. Why I'm drawing this particular picture is all the concepts which we are learning afterwards, sorry, the P atmosphere. Okay, all the concepts which we are going to learn are constructed around this particular one. So the pressure inside the cylinder is less than the atmosphere, automatically water started climbing. This entire cylinder got filled with the water. Then he used a valve to stop the downpour. Now afterwards, what he did, he again opened the valve. This high pressure steam started pushing the water. Now how do I encash this one? He connected this particular one to a highest height possible wherever I want to store the water, maybe a big tank. From the ground, you can have some kind of pillar, etc. Now this water, because there is a high pressure steam which is pushing the water, all the water went up. Okay, then it filled the cylinder. Now once it is empty from the water, and the steam will replace the water into, the cylinder will be replaced with the steam. Then again you close the steam valve and pour the water on the top, it will condense. Now you see, he created a cyclic event which is essential for development of more sustainable product. What is the one? Process one, fill the cylinder with the steam. Process 2, cool the steam, create a vacuum. Process 3, automatically water will climb. Once the water cylinder fills with the water, then you again push it with the steam, then the water will rise up. Once the entire steam is filled, again you cool it. So alternately he did a process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. So the great innovation, in fact, no, the if you read more about this particular person, he is the one who created a new era to the thermodynamics. Okay, the cyclic devices are immortal. If you develop any device which is cyclic, it will last long. You imagine 200 years still we are depending on IC engines which work in a cycle, and 150 years there is a steam power plant, we depend on them. There are 70 years there are refrigerators, air conditioners. Why these are serving for so long, they are still becoming important. All these devices, no, depend on one of the most powerful thermodynamic concept. Okay, you see this one, the cyclic devices. So whenever I develop, it should be a cyclic device. If it is a cyclic device, then that particular innovation will last long, and it will have the highest benefit to the society. All these cyclic devices, if you think indirectly, what I am doing with the car engine, what I am doing with the refrigerator, what I am doing with the air conditioner, you see this one, I am consuming energy more outside the body than inside the body. Then automatically what will happen? My extrasomatic events are satisfied. And I am doing the major job for which nature created us. What is that? Convert the carbon reservoirs back into the atmosphere for the sake of better conversion. This is the one. You see, I'm giving, you can go through the web and try to search about this person. You will get a lot of description. He exhibited great fondness for mechanics and for mathematicians, natural philosophy, and gave much time to experimenting. He wanted to develop a motion, number one. At the same time, he want to observe the natural philosophy, apply the mathematics, and all these things is experimenting also, not just developing a mathematical model and leaving it. In fact, no, if you see so many flavors in a thermodynamics which we are going to learn, you can say that this person gave all the flavors to start with. After his innovation, no, it gave him more opportunities. His engine was very primitive. Okay, then immediately there is a person called a newcomer who modified and produced a better engine. Now this engine started pumping water from mines. Most of the sugar factories were using this particular one. Operation of these things I'll take up later when I'm explaining some thermodynamic processes. And in fact, now few thousand to a million such engines were used everywhere. Okay, so the first time, all of you know the stories of James Watt. Okay, the James Watt got exposed by chance to this particular engine. Then the James Watt studied more carefully. What James Watt's interest was, this engine is working well. Somehow, this is wasting a lot of steam power and not utilizing the entire steam power to pump the water. Then he went to a owner who was using the newcomer engine, told him that, I want to produce a better engine. That owner said, what do you mean by a better engine? I want to pump 10 liters of water per hour, it is doing, I don't want a bigger one. Can you believe that till James Watt entered into this particular engineering, better engine means bigger engine. There is nothing better than that. The James Watt could not understand how to define a better engine. Then he went back and came back on the two days or so. Then he explained to the owner of that company, who has a lot of money, who can invest, he said this particular point. I'll develop an engine which will pump same amount of water, that is 10 liters per hour of water, but it will consume less fuel. Then he was very happy. Do you mean it? So first time in the history of development, James Watt created a concept called efficiency, performance. You see, even now, if I go to a market to buy a car, first thing which we ask is the mileage. how many kilometers I can run by consuming 1 liter of the fuel, which is essential for developing of better engines throughout the career. So you can see this particular Thomas James Watt's engine. Okay, so he made a more and more engineering into this particular one. And when you see Thomas Avery, Newcomen and James Watt, there is a similarity. All of them want to have a cyclic device. There are cyclic operations. What Newcomen did, a better cycle than the Thomas Avery, but cycle. What James Watt did, another better processes, but it is a cycle. So there is a series of developments which are happening, and every engine was doing a series of events in a cyclic fashion. And all of you know the contribution of James Watt engine, and it changed the lifestyle on the globe. Before James Watt, Newcomen engine, Thomas Avery engine only used for water pumping, nothing else. But the day James Watt worked with a better model, he developed a double act engine. Then 1784 there was a Watt's hammer, helped the construction industry to break the rocks, stones and create a good construction material. All of you know the celebrated research or a development using the James Watt engine. Thomas Wick invented a locomotive which created the first level of motion on the land, and you can go on inventing. So later you know that the Great Atlantic was the first ship which ran with the James Watt. What I want to say here is turning an idea or an equipment into a more classical way will lead to many, many developments based on the same idea. What is that fundamental idea which should be there, which you will live in for a long time, is a cyclic operation of a machine, which thermodynamics is built on that particular concept. So all of you should imagine that though the definition of the cycle is a two-line statement, there is a 250 years of effort from Thomas Avery to James Watt, which made that a cycle is so important, and later everybody start doing research about newer cycles also. So at the end of the day, now you see, now steam engine became as an alternative to the horse, as an alternative to the cattle. In fact, no, I'm telling in the lighter way, all the horses and cattle on the ground on this globe will thank the James Watt, you have saved our life. Otherwise, these people would have killed us to produce the motion for 10 kilometers, 20 kilometers, 100 kilometers. After the James Watt engine, perhaps we did not depend much upon. That's where, no, the horse power comes from, replacing the power of the horse. That's how the James Watt engine started ruling the industry like anything. And meanwhile, there is something which has happened with this particular person, you know very well. After this person, the people wrote the thermodynamics as a subject. Till that, there are foundations, there are concepts which are laid. Nobody articulated them properly. What made this person to force that a better articulation? Let me discuss about this person, very important. We learn the Carnot cycle, but don't understand why this person is so important in the development of thermodynamics. All of us know the great grandfather of the second law is the Carnot. His invention and his involvement made a formal thermodynamics subject. Okay, let me start with this particular person. Did a military engineering in 1814. After doing the military engineering, okay, then he started working on what is called mathematical theory of heat engine. So you see this one, the entire world is thinking in one way. This boy started thinking in the other way. What the world was thinking, you try to develop an engine, you try to develop an engine, better engine, bigger engine, or a better performance of the engine, etc. But this boy said that there should be a fundamental mathematical theory behind the heat getting converted into motion. That is the one what he said, that which helped in a modern theory of thermodynamics. You see this one? His fundamental idea is to develop a good cycle or a good steam engine. But that thinking should come with a mathematical theory. And he met okay, and he observed this one. The steam power was doing everything on the globe, but it was not at all efficient. This boy wanted to understand, well, before I develop an equipment, can I do something on the paper, some calculations on the paper, and based on that, I can say a better engine is possible. What is that mathematical model which should be practiced before I construct an engine and led to a great subject called thermodynamics? So what are the queries before I actually develop an engine which is going to consume lot of natural resources and satisfy my extrasomatic actions? Okay, and what should be done in between? You see this particular one, and a man who proved that a blend of science and mathematics and ingenuity is a good engineering. What are the, sorry, the first query of the Carnot? So the first and foremost point which entered into his mind is, what is the, okay, role of temperature okay so is there a role of temperature on the engine at all? In fact, no, he met all those people who had a 50 years of experience in designing the engines. What did he do? He went to them, asked a question. Okay, what is the question? He said, what happens if I increase the maximum temperature? So instead of I burn the same amount of fuel, but by burning, while burning and produce steam, if I do something that the temperature of the steam will be the highest, will it be good? Or what will happen? And at the end of the day, he asked a more fundamental question, which became a powerful question. Everybody started thinking about this big question. What is this big question? If I have a 1 kg of coal, how much water I should pump, or how much energy I should generate? Do you know what is the capability of 1 kg of fuel? And without knowing that, how can you say that I have developed a better engine? That's how, no, he created more queries, more questions, and developed what is called a thermodynamic vision of development. And so it's, thermodynamics is not just developing an engine, though historically the historical events which led to the development of thermodynamics is obviously the power generation, generation of motion, everybody will accept. But this particular thing developed a practice. Now what is the thermodynamic vision? You try to learn some primitive concepts. Why? Without knowing the primitive concepts, if I start developing an engine, I develop an engine better than the past. You see this one, when the James Watt entered and he found that the Newcomen engine was 1/10 of what he could do. When the James Watt modified the Newcomen engine, it started producing 10 times more power with the same amount of fuel consumption. But the question is, 10 times better than the Newcomen is the best? No. Then that's why one need to define the primitive concept. You need to understand what is the resource, what is the requirement. Once you understand the primitive concepts, no, then you can develop a creative secondary concepts. Okay, in, you imagine the nature gave the fuel and we wanted the motion. In between, we created more concepts like pressure, temperature, enthalpy, energy. All these were important. Without that, no, I could not convert that fuel into motion in a better way. So then the moment I have the secondary concepts, then you propose a theory. Without having a primitive and secondary concept, one cannot propose a theory. Then nobody can understand that theory at all. The way we are going to learn many theorems, many laws, zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, second law of thermodynamics, all these laws you can appreciate only when you understand these two primitive concepts. Okay, without understanding these primitive concepts, you know, perhaps the theory looks very academic in nature. You can never use this particular theory in your real life, and you will never become a good inventor. You may be working for somebody but not really a creator of new ideas and concepts. So the moment I propose a theory, I should test the theory by doing some experiment or by developing equipment. Then the moment I test the theory, then I'll create what is called the acceptance of theory. Everybody will start using this theory. How the people start using this theory, you see, there is one way is from the beginning you develop a theory. From the beginning you develop a powerful theory. But thermodynamics is not only interested in just developing the theories. No, it will help you in the other way. You can see this particular one. Same thermodynamics will help you to do this one step by step. Particular relations using this one. If I have a first law of thermodynamics, I'll apply the first law of thermodynamics for various equipment. Maybe turbine, maybe a boiler, maybe some other process. But that is also a part of thermodynamics, using a theory for developing more and more new ideas. Then use that particular theory to engineering relations. So I'll develop some engineering formula. Suppose if there is a company which is producing the steam turbines, they will not learn every day from the beginning. They need to have some relation which they will immediately use to calculate the diameter, length, your selection of material, thickness of material. All these will come from the engineering relations. Once you accept the theory and translate the theory into useful form, okay, so then there will be many, many industrial processes. What is the goal of all the industrial processes which we are developing? To satisfy the extra somatism. Then there will be an impact on the society. Without anything, the society will remain. I'm trying to recall that advertisement on Mentos. Without realizing the extra somatic, the donkey and monkey were living together. In fact, the donkey was dominating the monkey. In the advertisement, he showed how the monkey evolved. The day monkey started learning the extra somatism, it constructed a big cart and made the donkey as its servant, and there is a impact on his social life. The same thing is very, very important too. In fact, no, thermodynamics is constructed out of this one. So that's how, no, there are two phases in the thermodynamics and learning. I'll stop it after this particular point. The first one is induction of concepts. So what I am trying to teach in this classroom is induction of concepts. But all the teachers which are listening to my lecture along with the students, what you will do, know the deduction of the concepts. Means after I state the first law, second law, zeroth law, some of the fundamental theorems, you will use those one for maybe a formula for a turbine operation, formula for engine operation, formula for a boiler operation. So that's how. So the deduction part will be done locally by the teachers as a part of first course, and the induction part will be done by me. Why? Because the theories are the one which got out of the, you believe me or not, a billion years of human experience, but the most faster growth in the three centuries, 17th, 18th and 19th century. And 20th century started enjoying the thermodynamics, and so much that the society started using the everything. There is an impact of thermodynamics on the society, both in positive sense, maybe pollution, maybe ozone layer depletion, global warming. Even these things also a concern in a thermodynamics. So what I wish to say that is, I'll put now the syllabus, and whatever I am going to teach is induction of the thermodynamic concepts. What you will teach locally with your students is deduction of these concepts into equipment development, engineering relations or so. Okay, thank you. Any question? So if there are some questions, we can take up those questions. better if you can send by a message, because so that I can read it to everybody and answer. Anything? No. So in the next class, I'll take up this formal primitive concepts, which are essential to understand. Again and again, I'm repeating, don't learn like any other subject, because within an 1 hour also somebody can learn these primitive concepts, but he'll never get to know how to use them to create a new product. If you want to become a real inventor, it is very essential that you will understand the primitive and secondary concepts to the bottom of their origin. Superficial understanding will lead to entire your engineering life very superficial, not a hardcore engineering. That is my urge. So that's how on Friday we will learn the first important part of this thermodynamic course, that is the primitive concepts, the role of primitive concepts in a real engineering product. I'll stop it here. And if there are any queries, you can raise the questions now. Okay. Why the things happen in the nature are cyclic? So somehow now it's the philosophy of the matter and energy. If you imagine now, we being Indians, very easy to understand this particular concept. The energy is like a soul and matter is like a body. The soul and body now have to interact continuously to create a freshness. You imagine if all those species on the earth, like a fossils forever, they get created once and they will not change. Then what will happen? It is like a Saturn or a Mars. There is nothing happening at all. If you want to have a continuous freshness, and that continuous happening has to be a long term, perhaps only one obvious idea is happening in a cycle. You imagine, if the entire 24 hours are big sunlight, perhaps I'll not feel like sleeping nicely. If the entire 24 hours are dark, then I can't do anything, because every living species requires a lot of light, energy, radiation or so. So a day should be divided in a cycle, some part with energy where I'll be very active, but being a living species, after working for a some time, I get tired. So I should get the environment which will help me to relax. When can I relax? If it is the night, and then I can sleep. But that night should last long. By the morning, no, because of this relaxing, I'll become a more powerful. I'll do the job again with the same enthusiasm. If I work 24 hours into 7 without any rest, obviously I'll not do great things at all. It looks like doing anything perfectly for a long time. I said it, no, the immortality to everything happens if it is a cycle. Yeah. Hello. Not able to hear. Not able to hear. Okay, thank you. We'll continue with the primitive concepts in next class. Now I'll load the syllabus, because I have created a base for what should be the syllabus. That is the reason why I delayed the concepts. Thank you. Thank you.